From what I understand from doctors, that's really rare. If it's a legitimate rape, the female body has ways to try to shut that whole thing down. But let's assume that maybe that didn't work or something.
Can you imagine if that didn't work? All right, now that's the guy, of course, running for Senate in Missouri against Claire McCaskill. He's a longtime Republican congressman. So what the hell did he mean by the woman has this ability to shut it down, etc.? Well, obviously he doesn't know what the hell he's talking about. He gets in a world of trouble. Then he's going to start backpedaling. Now here's his excuse to Sean Hannity, and then I will tell you the reality of where he got that idea.
My only point in that was I had heard from medical reports that rape is such a traumatic type of thing that that there is a reaction. But I, you know, that's wrong, and that's the second thing I've apologized for.
No, I understand that, but what did you mean by the female body has a way to try and shut that whole thing down? I didn't understand it.
Well, I had heard one time a medical report that said that it's hard to get it's harder for somebody to get pregnant under those conditions. I don't believe that's true now. I, in fact, have checked the facts that that's wrong.
It is not from a medical report. He could never cite a medical report. I'll tell you where it's actually from. It's from a book originally published in 1971 from Dr. Jack Wilkie, who argued that women have natural hormones, that if it's an assault rape, that those hormones, et cetera, are released and the woman's body resists the semen in that case and will not get fertilized. Now, Dr. Jack Wilkie is a total and utter moron, and none of that is true. In fact, there are 32,000 cases every year of pregnancies resulting from rape. 32,000. Now, Dr. Jack Wilkie is not some sort of ridiculous Council of Zion guy that only Todd Akin read in a library in the 1970s. No, he's one of their most respected leaders. In fact, when he endorsed Mitt Romney was quite literally, quote, said he was proud to have Dr. Wilkie's endorsement, and what a bastion of the pro-life movement that he is. That's where all these kooks get this crazy idea. So it's not something Akin made up. It's not his doctor friend told him something ridiculous that applies to ducks but not to humans. No, this is actually a right-wing ideology that a lot of them believe. One of the things that they're most angry about with Akin is, damn it, why did you let everybody know? We're supposed to keep that crazy stuff to ourselves. So that is where he got his so-called mistake. That's point number one. Point number two is this idea about legitimate rape, right? So he says, well, I misspoke. Now, get a load of what he just told Huckabee on his radio program about how he misspoke. This is really important. Listen.
What did you mean by legitimate rape? Were you attempting to say forcible rape, or was that just, where did that come from?
Well, yeah, I was talking about forcible rape, and it was absolutely the wrong word.
So he says, I didn't mean legitimate rape. I meant forcible rape. Do you understand that? So what he's saying is there are a lot of things that are not forcible rape. Like, come on, we're going to count date rape? Hey, you heard that slut already went upstairs with the guy. Of course he was going to do whatever he wanted. He was horny. He's a guy. By the way, this is true of all fundamentalists from all the different religions. The Muslims feel the same way. Oh my God, well, of course we had to cover up the woman. If you said man saw even an ankle or an elbow of a woman, he would of course rape her, right? It only counts if it's forcible rape. Statutory rape, your dad or your uncle raped you when you were 13, or your neighbor raped you when you were 13. Well, that's statutory rape. It's not necessarily forcible rape. Did you cry out? It says in the Bible, if you're outside or inside a city, something along those lines, you gotta cry out. If you didn't cry out, it's not forcible rape. Who cares? You gotta have the kid, you gotta have the rapist kid. We're making that decision for you. But that word forcible rape is also not something that's an accident or it's a throwaway or it's only applies to Akin. No, Akin and Ryan passed a whole bill, or they tried to pass a bill in the House. In fact, they were the co-sponsors of it. It was called the No Taxpayer Funding for Abortion Act. And it said, hey, listen, Already the federal government, this before Akin O'Ryan comes in, says you cannot get money for an abortion if you're on Medicaid, right? But there's an exception. If you're raped, you can get money for it, because a lot of times poor women are raped and they don't have money for an abortion, and it's not their fault, and you should be allowed to get one. Now, that's what we have decided as a society. That's what even the Republicans claim. Oh, yeah, sure, right. But in reality, that's what they say on TV. In reality, this is a legislation they're trying to pass by Akin and Paul Ryan, co-sponsors, saying, oh, no. If you're allowed to get an abortion, and have it paid for by Medicaid if you've been raped, it has to be a forcible rape. It can't be one of those things like date rape and statutory rape that doesn't count. No, you got to show it to us. You got to prove to us how forcible it was. Did you resist enough? These people are sick. They don't believe that it's a real rape if it's not so-called forcible rape in their minds. That wasn't an accident by Akin. He meant it. He put it in a bill. He put those words, and you just heard him say to Huckabee, yes, I meant forcible rape. What is forcible? You have to hit her a couple of times? You have to break her jaw? Just pull on her hair? What's forcible rape, you sick son of a bitch? No, but they're going to make these decisions for you, right? By the way, it's not just him. Now, of course, the Republicans say, oh, this is not our stance. No, of course not. Let's hear the sellout Arthur Davis, who switched from corporate Democrat to corporate Republican. Let's hear from him.
And what every single Republican senator or leader who's weighed into this has said, his comments don't reflect the pro-life movement, they don't reflect the Republican Party, and they don't reflect the Romney.
No, it doesn't reflect the Republican Party at all. I'll get to that in 1 second. But also, Reince Priebus, the head of the RNC, the Republican National Committee.
What he said, Aaron, was biologically stupid. It's something that nobody on either side of the aisle agrees with.
Really? Then how do you explain the GOP platform that just came out? Quote, the unborn child has a fundamental individual right to life which cannot be infringed. Meaning no exception for rape, no exception for incest, no exceptions, period. You get raped, you suffer incest, statutory, it doesn't matter. You're gonna have the rapist child. In fact, this is even worse than what Akin and Ryan co-sponsored. Because this says, I don't care if it's forcible or not. You got forced to rape. Who cares? I don't care if he broke your jaw while raping you. I don't care what the hell he did to you. You're having the rapist child. It's in the GOP platform. This is the document that says, this is what we as a party stand for. I'll give you more from the platform. Quote, we support a human life amendment to the Constitution and endorse legislation to make clear that the 14th Amendment's protections apply to unborn children. They're going to put in an amendment in the Constitution, if they can, to make sure not only do you have no legal right to abortion, but under no circumstances do you have that right. This is not your decision to make. Now look, Huckabee comes in and says, what are you talking about? There's all these lovely people that came from rape. We should celebrate it. You think I'm exaggerating? Watch. I want to go to here, clip 16.
Ethel Waters, for example, was the result of a forcible rape. I used to work for James Robison back in the 1970s. He leads a large Christian organization. He himself was the result of a forcible rape. And, so I know it happens, and yet, even from those horrible, horrible tragedies of rape, which are inexcusable and indefensible, life has come, and sometimes, those people are able to do extraordinary things.
So, hey, listen, man, we can get some extraordinary things out of your rape. So, let's go forward. Now, who's going to make that decision on whether you carry the rapist child, whether it was forcible or not? Of course it's not you. Don't be silly. It's Representative Akin and Mike Huckabee and all those incredibly moral guys on the right-wing side who will decide what you do with your body after the rapist has decided what to do with your body. But of course, they don't represent the Republican Party except for the fact that it's in their platform for what they stand for.